Welcome back to the fifth installment of TNT with myself, Tyler Patner, and Travis Patton from Airgun Depot. We got together, sat down, talked about some hot topics in the industry back in June of 2019, releasing the videos now for you guys to see. Today's video is all about airgun slugs and airguns only a mother could love. Check it out.
I don't think they'll dominate the industry, but they'll move a lot more mainstream. I mean, right now, fringe is not the word, but it's a very small percentage of the airgunning community that's shooting slugs. Yeah. It's a really niche sort of aspect right now.
It's a niche of a niche.
it is. Yeah. You know, traditionally, it's kind of been like, well, slugs are not as accurate, but for long distances, they're more accurate, because they buck the wind better, they've got better BC, and so they're less affected by everything else. But now they're getting to where, you know, even at short ranges, they're nearly as accurate as pellets or can be. For me, I have mixed feelings about slugs, just because I think, well, what really got me to fall in love with air guns again was the fact that I could shoot them in my backyard. Mm-hmm. I liked that terrible BC because the pellet loses energy. If I'm shooting 177, you know, in my backyard, it's not going to go through anything because it's lost so much energy by the time it's gone 20 yards. Whereas with a slug, I mean, it's retaining that energy and it's got a lot of punch. Your backstops have to be better and, you know, you've got to be a lot more conscious about that.
Sure. So right now, being a kind of niche thing, right, the cost is somewhat high, I would say. I mean, from what I've seen, at least. Yeah.
So relatively speaking, compared to pellets.
Yeah, exactly. So for me, I don't think I can embrace it. I understand the benefits from a ballistics perspective, absolutely, and what they do in the right barrel at distance compared to what a pellet can do at that same distance is you just can't argue it, and I wouldn't even try. But because of where the cost is at, they'll never dominate pellets. And I don't think you'll be able to get that cost down that much. A lot of this has to do, though, I think, with two things. Number one is that right now it's a niche thing. So, yes, it's going to gain popularity. I agree with you 100% as people want to start extending the distances and looking for just the very best accuracy. But this is all led by the manufacturers of guns. So for pellet manufacturers, JSB and H&N are a perfect example. Both have said that they're pursuing slugs at this point in time. So that right there will bring the cost down. Just by having these major players get into it. But right now we have one or two companies really in the industry, gun-wise, that are trying to push slugs. And I think you have to see more manufacturers get on board with that before it's really going to have any sort of long lifespan. Because right now, if you have to buy a $2,000 gun or a $1,000 gun to get into that, that's tough. You're talking about a small segment of the air gun market, you know, and nobody's talking about making a slug for a spring gun, right? Or making a slug that works in a spring gun barrel. So, you know, some of those things could completely change this conversation. But right now it's just a niche. Yeah. That's the way I see it.
Yeah. I mean, the constraints are on how the barrel is made.
Right.
Right. I mean, if it's got a really aggressive choke, then it's generally just not going to shoot them. Yeah. So there's a couple for me.
Yeah, I think I have two in my head right now. Yeah.
I mean, for me, the Benjamin Bulldog is one of these guns that just...
I understand where you're coming from. I don't necessarily agree. Like, I'm not saying it's a great-looking gun, but it's also certainly not the worst. Like, for me, like, the Avonix Rainstorm 3D, and then also, like, I think borrowing from that, the Crawl Puncher Armor... Like, just hideous gun.
I mean, and the Crawl Puncher Armor is worse because it's just like got the bit screwed on with Phillips head screws.
The thing that they deciding to do colors was a bad idea. Yeah. Like, should have just done a gunmetal gray or a black and called it a weekend, you know?
Nobody wants a pink gun made out of sheet metal.
The other one, for me, there's a Chinese gun. It's a QB, and I think you have one. Because I believe it was a Stranger Guns thing at one point in time. And you brought it. Lovely. Do you agree?
This is
what is that? Like,
you know, this is so ugly that you almost like it. You know what I mean? It's kind of like that that ugly kid next door who really has kind of a good personality, but it takes years for you to realize it because you can't look at him.
That was really in depth.
this is one of those guns that, I mean, you just think.
Who did this? So doesn't this also take down?
Yeah.
Like, I'm pretty sure it does. Like, who was on what kind of drugs came up with this idea?
But more people should take that stuff. Yeah. I mean, that's just...
You know what? I don't even want to touch it, actually. Now, that definitely takes the cake for me, though. That's
side lever, take down.
That's the only good part about it, though, is that it's a side lever.
Springer.
Yeah.
With and then somebody put this $2 scope on top.
That's the way it should be.
Yeah, this is it.
Yeah, for me, that's absolutely.
I mean, if anyone has a better one, I want to see it.
Yes, send pictures.
That's actual production. Of course, we don't care. If it's one you made in your backyard, send pictures too.
Yeah, unless it's all made out of PVC and wood, then we don't care. But like an actual air gun, that'd be interesting to see. Yeah. Thanks for joining us today for this episode of TNT. We appreciate you guys watching. If you liked the video, go ahead, hit us with a like down below. Let us know what you thought about our take on the airgun slugs and where they're going in the industry, as well as some of the ugliest airguns. Do you agree with us? Do you disagree? Let us know down in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to both channels so you stay up to date on all the latest TNT footage. We'll see you guys next time.